Hi, everyone. I'm Lauren Albandian. I am the coordinator for ESAR 2022. And ESAR 2022 is happening August 25th through the 29th. It'll be held in Westminster, Colorado. That is right between Denver and Boulder. And so it'll be at the Westminster. And so you'll have the view of the lovely Rocky Mountains. It'll be summer. It's going to be gorgeous. We have 100 speakers. We have 120 lectures or more with workshops and such. So you can go to esar2022.org to find out all the information you will need to know. And hopefully you will join us where we will be, as our tagline says, joining hearts and minds with our fellow astrologers, renewing friendships and creating new ones. So today I'm with my friend and colleague, Sue Jonasson, and she is from Norway. And let me tell you a little bit about Sue if you don't know who she is. She has studied astrology since her teens and worked professionally since 1999. And her primary education is evolutionary astrology with Maurice Fernandez. But she's also studied esoteric and psychological astrology with other teachers. And her work is primarily consultations, combining her astrological skills with her other degrees as a certified meditation instructor and soul flow therapist. I have a question before I talk to you about your lectures, because you're doing two of them. Are you excited about everybody coming back together? Are you excited about seeing people and except in this virtual format?
You know, it was good, the virtual format. It was nice to just chill down a little bit. And I've had a great time, actually, with the pandemic in that sense that I love being in my own territory. But now I'm really getting excited. Now it's really dawning on me that I'm actually traveling again and going to Colorado. I love Colorado. It's an amazing place. So I've been there before. And I'm very much looking forward to meeting old friends and just hanging out and do some real nerdy astrology speak again, because it's been a while. It's going to be nice. Yeah, absolutely. I'm looking so much forward.
There's nothing like being in a space where you don't have to explain your language. You don't have to predefine or have any consideration or concern about what other people, their judgments might be. So it's really a special environment to be in the conference setting. It really is. So you're doing two lectures, one on Friday the 26th and one on Sunday the 28th. And your first lecture is near and dear to my heart as an astrologer. You're dealing with Ceres, attachment styles, and codependency. So talk to us about that.
Well, you know, there is these levels of, we have what's called attachment style. Some people attach by healthy, or what can you say, like a more healthy attachment style, where you have the capacity to be transparent and open and honest with how the inner world and the outer world interacts in a relationship, you know, how somebody's behavior might cause some emotional stir in you. But from a healthy attachment style, there's room for sharing without triggering any defense mechanisms that can cause a lot of disruption in a relationship. When it's unhealthy or when it's traumatized, when there's deep trauma underneath, and Ceres is a planet of loss, you know, there's always this, it's categorized together with Pluto, so it's a dwarf planet, and they share the same mythology. So there's something with change that comes in with Ceres that might not always be so happy, or like it could have taken away something called inner security, a thing that's very important for us in order to be in healthy and secure attachment styles. So that develops other types of attachment styles where you might have like withdrawal, the avoidant attachment style, you have the people pleaser, you have the nervous, anxious attachment styles. So my studies with Ceres have brought me into these different kinds of situations, you know, where I had to explore the intimate field between people just to check out, you know, how can we reach a level where we do not attempt to control the outcome of our interaction? And very often where you see Ceres in a chart, you always you get a sense of their attachment styles, and you get a sense of their whether or not they try to control the outcome, the response, and in order to secure safety, in order to secure themselves from feeling anxiety. So that's what this lecture is going to be about. So it's
And we did have a friend in the background, we'll acknowledge, because we
I'm sorry, I just...
No, don't be sorry. Don't be sorry.
Always doing this every time.
It's an extra added bonus that is marvelous, that, you know.
Well, that's Galadriel, it's my cat. She's
Galadriel is just joining the conversation, that's all.
She's Gemini, she has to. Listen, I have something to say. She's very vocal.
Exactly. So your second lecture is on Sunday the 28th, and this one sounds like it's a bit more technique driven. It's called How to Use Composites. So for those who don't know what a composite is, can you do just a real short summary of what a composite is?
There are two composite charts. One is Davison relationship charts, and the other one is the midpoint chart. The midpoint chart is what I normally use. I look at both methods, of course. The midpoint chart is just a hypothetical chart, and it's the midpoint between two planets. So you and me, let's say we were in opposite signs, then of course the midpoint between us would be the third, the energy that we created. So it's a midpoint chart, the midpoint between Venus and Venus in a chart, Mars and Mars in a chart, the angles and angles. So you get a new chart, and that's the energy of the relationship. The Davison chart is the midpoint in between the dates, the actual dates, right? So that's more locational, and it's more, well, it's different, right? So then you get a new date, the relationship itself has its own birth date. Right. So but I've been studying, you know, it's for me it's invaluable to use these charts when I'm doing synastry work, and a lot of people come into astrology in order to understand not just themselves but also the people that they relate to. And that's one of the best advantages we have actually with astrology, is that we get to understand our own shadow, our own blind spots. We get to understand other people and their uncommunicated stuff, you know, things we normally just have to guess, you know. And the composite chart is extremely interesting as a third energy, you know, like this is the composite energy of you and me. And the transits to them are so incredibly important, you know, how to kind of understand the timing, the unfolding, the different rhythms, the different cycles of relationship as a whole is going through. So I've done so much work on that particular part of it, especially the transits to the composite chart. So I'm really eager to share that, because I think it's still something I find a lot of literature on, and it hasn't been written a lot on. Composite charts is a fairly new technique. It was brought into, you know, the astrology world, I think, in the 70s. And so, it's an area in astrology that still is like wide open for research, and there's so much to discover yet. And so I think, you know, that's going to be fascinating for people to kind of like get their head into, because it's like, oh, something new. And it's very fun to work with, because it points to relationships, which I think is so incredibly important to people to understand. I mean, we really use astrology in that way, that we try to figure out, is he the one or is she the one, or what is going on here, you know?
Everybody wants to know about their relationships. So at ESAR, we have a whole topic track of relationship lectures, and both of yours are on in that topic track. And so, look, you know, romance, relationships, sex, money. These are, you know, the pretty common questions that, you know, what about my work? What about my career? What about my relationship? You know, I want to understand what's going on here, or when is the next relationship coming into my life? These are questions that we hear a lot. So come to ESAR, everyone. come to East Park and join us. Meet us there. We're going to have so much fun. We've got a lot of events planned for outside of lecture time. So go to ESAR Astrology, ESAR2022.org. ESARAstrology.com is actually ESAR's website. But for the conference, go to ESAR2022.org and join us August 25th through the 29th in Westminster, Colorado for the conference. Thanks so much, Sewell, for taking the time to be with me today. I really appreciate it.
Thank you. And well, Galadriel says hi, evidently. It's time to go down with it. Oh, this cat.
Oh. All right. Well,